Love, you've captured me again. Love, you steal my heart. And oh, when I reach out, you're always
I still have joy
after all the things we've been through.
I still have joy
after all the things we've been through.
I still have peace
after all the things we've been through.
I still have faith
after all the things we've been through.
I still have hope
after all the things we've been through.
I still have love
after all the things we've been through.
I still have joy
after all the things we've been through. After all the things we've been through, I still have joy.
We try. soul, are you weary and troubled? No light in the darkness you see. There's light for a look at the Savior, and life more abundant and free. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim. In the light believe him and all will be well. Then go to a world that is dying, his perfect salvation to tell. Oh, turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory.
Well, here we are again, virtual Riverside service. I'd like to welcome to the service, and I hope you're looking forward to spring just like I am. And we're in Philippians, and it won't be a while before you see me in virtual church until Easter. Ron is hoping to present a message for next week, and then Paul has something for Palm Sunday. And I'm looking forward to seeing what Paul has, and looking forward to seeing Ron giving a message again. And just want to welcome you back, Ron, for next week. And I'd like you to turn to Philippians chapter 4. That's where I'm still at. And today's message is one that really can make a difference in our lives. And I just believe that Paul wrote some very interesting things here. It's in chapter 4, verse 8 and 9, and I'm just going to read them and going to talk about them and come to a conclusion at the end. And it says here, finally, brothers, whatever's true, whatever's noble, whatever's right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. Here's some verses that just give a list of words. And we've gone through having our confidence in God. We've gone through just having the message preached and the power in the message, and the message being Jesus Christ died for our sins so we can have a home in heaven. And when we accept this and believe this, then it's our role to shine for him, to serve him. And then he once again reminds us that our confidence cannot be in ourselves, but in Jesus Christ. And then he says, when tough times come, we need to press on and keep moving to the goal of our resurrection in Christ. And then he says to the Philippian church, there's a couple ladies that need to solve a disagreement they have. And I entitled that message, Getting Along with One Another, and how important that is. And then one of the happiness or joyfulness robbers is worry, and that was last week's message. And we can have a peace that passes understanding by turning over our worry to God. And then today it picks up. He gives these nine different words. He says, whatever is true, and true means steadfast, loyal, honest, or accurate. He says, whatever is noble or honest in the King James, possessing outstanding qualities. Whatever is right or just in the King James, being in accordance with what is just, good, and proper. And he says, whatever is pure, spotless or stainless, free from harshness or roughness, free from being polluted or fault or guilt. And he says, whatsoever is lovely, lovable, delight for beauty, harmony, or grace, whatever is lovely. And then he says, whatever is of admirable or good report, it says in the King James, to marvel or to regard, think high of. And then he says, whatsoever is of excellent. Excellent. Anything that's excellent. Or in the King James, it says virtue. Standard of right, conform to, very good of its kind, eminently good, a high standard. And then he says, anything that's praiseworthy, laudable, worthy of praise, commendable. He says, think on these things. And when you think about that, what we are is what we think. Whether we realize that or not, what we think about, what we focus on, a lot of times is what we become. And he gave us two things before this that made a world of difference in what you think. Remember that disagreement between Udiah and Syntyche? They had a disagreement and he told them, come back together in the Lord. Remember how much you were helpful and spreading the gospel before? Let's get back together and focus on the good things we did together and the good things. Forget the disagreement. Forget the differences we have here. Let's focus on, let's be praiseworthy to one another. Let's be honest with one another. Let's be pure. Let's be lovely. Let's praise each other. And he says, it'll make a world of difference in your relationships. And it's not only in relationships of Udiah and Syntyche, it's also in relationships with family members, or in marriage, or in church, or co-workers. What you focus on, you can focus on the mistake that was made. You can focus on maybe somebody said something foolishly or a little demeaning, and you can focus on that, or you can focus on the more praiseworthy part or the pure part. It makes a world of difference. Try it sometimes. Go the opposite here. If you're married, try being negative with them all the time. Be critical. Be cynical. Be negative. How will that work? So what Paul's here is saying is really true. And that's the opposite of these things. Being true and honest and noble and just and right and pure and lovely and good report and admirable and virtue and excellent and praiseworthy. The opposite is being critical, cynical, complaining, and negative. You know as well as I do, that would never work in a marriage. If you're cynical, complaining, negative, and criticize all the time, that will never work. It won't create peace. It won't create peace in friendships. It won't create peace with your coworkers. It won't create peace in your family. So what Paul's talking about, it really makes a difference what we think about and what we focus on. Think about the other message that was here between the disagreement. And remember, it talked about rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. And then he says, let your gentleness be evident. He said, do not be anxious about anything. Anxious is worry, and worry is thinking. Thinking is can get us all worked up. And if you go back to verse 8, if you focus on the good things, it takes away the worry. Instead of worrying about the stuff in our lives, I'm not saying it's that easy, but what we focus on makes a world of difference of what we're going to worry about. That's what Paul's trying to say. He says, Philippian church, focus on the true, the noble, the right, the lovely, the lovable, the excellent, the praiseworthy. Look at them, and it will help you with your anxiety. And it is so true. It says in the Bible, so a man thinks, that's what he is. If we think about something long enough, you know what I'm talking about. There's that story that I always talk about, there's a pink elephant in the room. Well, there's no such thing as a pink elephant, but if you think about it long enough, you can start to think that maybe there is a pink elephant in the room. Sounds crazy. But what we think and what we focus on really makes a difference in our responses, our reactions, how we approach things. It is so true. It says to think on these things. Imagine a church filled with people thinking on the honest and the noble, the true, the right and the just, the pure, the lovely, the good report, the admirable, the virtue, the excellent, the praiseworthy. You can picture that. Picture going to church and people say, "Boy, you look good today. Boy, you look sharp and this and that. Oh, I heard you did this and you did a fine job." Now picture the opposite. Let's be opposite here. Go to a church or in a family, and when they come to church, "Boy, your shirt doesn't match with your pants." Be critical. "Boy, you could have done this differently. Boy, I don't like the way this is going." The three C's in the end, as I call them. Critical, complaining, and cynicism. And negativity. Folks, it is easy to be critical. It's part of our nature. It is easy to complain. It is easy to be cynical. It is easy to be negative. It's part of our sinful nature. But God, Paul, speaking for God, says, let's focus on the good things. Let's think about the good things. And, you know, Paul speaks this because he knows it makes a difference in relationships, what we focus on. And I shared that. He knows it makes a difference in our anxiety, which gives us peace that passes an understanding. Laying things at the feet of God, or just saying, "I don't want to focus on this about that person or about that group." But there's another reason why God, why God had this printed. Because when we focus on the negative, the critical, the cynicism, and the, I'm missing a C there, and the complaining instead of the positive things, it does something to you and I. It changes our spirit. It changes us on the inside. It affects us. A happy spirit really makes us blossom. A critical spirit dries us up. And it does something to us. And God knows it does something to us. This is the challenge to me, and I don't know exactly how to portray this, but I'm going to try my best. You can already see in the picture a rose. And I don't have enough camera space here to put the garbage bag in the whole picture. Life comes at us, and in life there's good things and there's bad. In life there's garbage, and it's there. And there's really beautiful things, roses. And these verses are asking us, as believers in Christ, wanting to glorify God He's telling us it really makes a difference what we focus on. And when we focus on things, we think about them a lot. Now we have a decision. There's roses and good things in life, and there's garbage and bad things in life. Now we have to decide. We can easily in life sit there and go, man, did you see the garbage? Wow, boy, that is really bad. Man, and I just can't believe, how are we going to do this? Like, did you see that garbage? Did you see what was going on? Oh my goodness. And we can just focus on that, and it really gets us down and really gets us bumming. And God says, you're going to have garbage in life, but don't focus on that. Think about the good things and put it and focus on the rose. Focus on the good things in life. Focus on the noble, the right, the admirable, the excellent, the praiseworthy. And this will give you a peace that passes understanding. It doesn't mean the garbage doesn't exist anymore. And this is the challenge, which I really don't know how to explain. There is garbage in life. There is good things. And sometimes we have to look at the garbage and deal with it. If you have garbage in your house, if you don't deal with it sooner or later and take it out, it's going to stink up your house. So you know it's there and you have to deal with it. Even though you got flowers on the kitchen table, you still got to take care of that garbage. And sometimes you do. But he doesn't want you focusing on the garbage the whole time. Just take it out. Take it out. Get rid of the smell. That's what we're thinking about makes a world of difference in our lives. We need to think about the good things and take out the garbage. Put the garbage to the rest. I couldn't help but think this last year was a prime example of COVID, the election, and some of the things happening around the world in our country, and we could sit and focus on COVID. We can sit and focus on the election. We can sit and focus on Blue Lives Matter and Black Lives Matter and all them different things. And there were things that we have had to hear about in the last year. And we can focus on, oh my, oh my, oh my, or we can just say, you know, there's a lot of, and there's a lot of good things out there. There's a lot of good things out there. And this is one thing that I struggle with. I need to see what's going on in our world in the news, but the news just seems to promote fear. And it's challenging for me, personally, to watch the news and not focus on the negatives. And sometimes I just have to turn it off. And what we focus on makes a world of difference in our lives. Doesn't mean we ignore the garbage. It just means we don't focus on it. We need to focus on. Remember what it said when you press on? To focus on the resurrection and there's a better day coming. What are you focusing on? It says at the end of these verses, it says, whatever you have learned from me or received or heard from me, remember he's in prison and seen in me, put it into practice and the God of peace will be with you. He says, when you focus on all these positive things, the rose gets bigger in your life. And that's what we want. That's what we want. That's what God is concerned about. Let's pray. Lord, help us to have a desire to implement in our lives these two verses, to make efforts to focus on the good things in life. Doesn't mean the bad things aren't happening, but what we focus on makes a world of difference in how we think and how it affects our lives. And I know, God, that you want us to have lives that are free of anxiety, free of disagreements, free of it affecting us, causing us to become bitter, angry, depressed, because we're focusing on all the garbage, so to speak. Lord, help us to turn it over to you. Praise in your name. Amen. And There's a verse that we will talk about later, but it fits well here. It says, I can do everything through Him who gives me strength. We can do this through the one who gives us strength. Have a good week.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Not be all else to me, say that thou art. Thou my best thought, by day or by night. Waking or sleeping, thy presence my light. Be thou my wisdom, and thou my true word. I ever with thee, and thou with me, Lord. Thou my great Father, and I thy true Son. Thou in me dwelling, bridges I need not, nor man's empty praise. Thou mine inheritance, now and always. Thou and thou only first in my heart. High King of heaven, my treasure. Not be